first change in buyers' buying behaviors is situational distrust. Distrust is like a snowball rolling down a hill. The more it rolls down the hill, the more it gains momentum and the faster it goes. Distrust is like that. If your buyer has distrust and it starts down that hill, it's going to continue down that hill. It's a downward spiral. We need to be able to stop that distrust as soon as we can, build that relationship, find a way to have trust between the two of you. And we need to do that in a non-salesy way. Think about the act of buying. When someone makes a purchase, they go through one up to four different emotions, and those emotions aren't always positive. They could feel anxiety, confusion, overwhelm, or stress at any time during a buying process. Overwhelmed because the buying process could be overwhelming to them. Confused because they might have too many choices or they don't know what choice to make. Stress, this purchase might not be in their budget. That can cause stress. And overwhelm, what do they do? If they make the wrong choice, what's at risk? So those four emotions already play into a buyer's purchase. Then we add in what has happened during the pandemic. Situational distrust. Think about it yourself. What has happened within daily life that can cause distrust? We have the media blast. We have what's happening within the political world. And then we have unfortunate human behavior that has caused such violence. Who do we trust? Who does your buyer trust? What has happened because of everything that is going on currently in our world, their trust meter has broken. Their trust meter is at the lowest it can possibly be. They are on high alert for manipulation, for someone who's being salesy, and in the situation itself. Think about it. Will they be safe or will they not? That adds another risk. And risk ends up causing distrust. It makes someone step back rather than step forward. Whether you're selling B2B or B2C, we need to keep this in mind. Our buyers are asking, can they trust you? Whereas, yes, it could have been part of the buying cycle originally. Now it's an important impact in the buying cycle. Mind in your sales conversations, be aware of any type of verbal or nonverbal communication that gives you a sign that the other person, that the buyer, has some distrust going on. Anytime there's a hesitation in a response, figure it out, because there's definitely something happened with inside that brain or that mindset of theirs. So is it causing distrust? It's a question you'll need to figure out and a question you need to understand before you move forward in the sales process.